Good afternoon and welcome to our second teleconferencing session on post basic BSc nursing for the third year students. We request the regional directors to kindly give us the attendance and also let us know how many students are there. Please facilitate them to communicate with us, and already our producer had rolled down the telephone number and fax number. Please do let us know the number of students attending the teleconference. Now this session, what we are going to talk about is what is nursing administration and management, and for that we have two experts of ours. On my extreme right we have Mrs. Rita Devi. She is a lecturer in School of Health Sciences. Immediate right we have Mrs. Sunita Patni, who is a senior faculty at Rajkumari Amrit Kaur College of Nursing and also is our senior academic counselor, course writer in the courses of Indira Gandhi National Open University. We are pleased to have both of you
Thank you.
What we think is that nursing is one program where the administration has to be done at all levels. It has to be done in the various settings. It has to be done in various situations to save the life of the patient. The doctor comes much later than what, as a nurse administrator, you have to make a decision. And that is why it is very significant for us to see that a nurse who works in various settings, various capacities, has got a role to play. Rita, would you like to introduce the topic of nursing administrator, nurse administrators and nurse, practitioners?
Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Nursing administration, like you post basic BSc nursing student, you started your career in the nursing field to, first of all, you become a staff nurse. So during the nursing career, you had experience of managing different wards, medical, surgical, pediatrics, operation theater, or in the community, you are working as first level managers. If you have necessary equipments and congenial atmosphere, then your job becomes rewarding and pleasurable. But if the necessary equipments are not there, atmosphere is not congenial, then your work can become strained and frustrations are created. So to make you a better, more effective and happier, next slide, happier nurse administrator, you should take into account several factors. Some of you might be, by seniority, you are gaining the qualities of an administrator. Some have inborn traits or personal qualities to be an administrator. Some are professional. All of you are having professional abilities to be an administrator, as well as the training also gives you the qualities to become a nurse administrator. So whatever be your background, you can improve and become a more effective administrator. So you have to develop skills of varying types by training and practice.
Now let's differentiate these two basic words, the administration and management. What is administration and what is nursing administration? Rita?
So administration, as the it is the word derived from a Latin word having ad and minister, which means to take care for or look after people. So, and if we see the definition of administration, it is a process of collective and cooperative efforts directed toward the realization of a consciously laid down goal and objectives by any organization. So the hospital where you are working or the community, these are the organizations, and the main objectives of any hospital is to take care of the patient. And if we see the management, it is a process by which the cooperative group directs action towards achievement of the goal. And if we can say in simple terms, management is getting the work done.
Right. So this is the basic difference between administration and management. What would be the significance then in nursing specifically?
Yeah, the significance of administration is the selection, provision and employment of resources for a desirable purpose. Nursing administration if we see, is a coordinated system of activities which provide total nursing care to the patient. And the, if we see the scope of the administration, it is very vast, almost limitless. We have to have administration whether we are working as first level manager, middle level or top level manager. Everywhere we have to have administration. If the administration is not there, then the work cannot be done properly.
Now, administration, as you very rightly said, is to administer. Whereas management is to get the work done, to execute, to see that the work is executed, to achieve the objectives of the a particular organization. And as you very rightly said, in the hospital we require the patient care to be effective, and whether it is in the community, we require the community should be healthy. Now, if we, as you also mentioned, that these are distinct terms, they are not the similar, they are the distinct terms, but they are interchangeably used, you know. Let's review some of the very, very important terms in administration, because sometimes we think of having the certain terms where we need to be very clear about it. Would you like to mention certain terms?
Yeah, there are certain terms, of course. First of all is the purpose. Like, what do you mean by purpose? Means the reason for which the organization exists. Why the organization is there, that forms the purpose of that organization. Other word we have already discussed is the philosophy, in which the beliefs, the values which guides the organization. We have already discussed in previous unit. Then goals or objective is another important term. Goals are the desired outcome, and what is our desired outcome as a nurse is patient care. The patient has to live independent life after his illness. Another term is organization. What is an organization? When a group of people work together to achieve the common goal, that is the organization. Another important term is concept. The concept means an idea, an understanding, an overall or general notion about that, which is concrete or abstract. That becomes the concept. Another important term is the abstract. What is abstract? That is which cannot be seen, but you can have the total of all impact or effect of that thing, but it cannot be visualized in the physical terms, but the effect can be there. Intangible is another important term, that means which cannot be touched or felt or seen. It is the effect only can be perceived. You can just perceive that if you walk in certain unit and see everything is intact, everybody is working as per their job requirement, then effect is seen, that good patient care is given to the patients in systematic manner. So that becomes intangible. Concrete is another term, that which occupies space, which has a form and can be seen, opposed to the abstract, in which you cannot see the effect, but in the concrete you can see the physical stack. Like the bed is something concrete. How the bed making is done in that particular word, so you can see if the bed making is properly done, then you can see that it is a, the work done is concrete.
Also, if the temperature comes down because of proper hydrotherapy, that means the result, it's a concrete result.
Yes, that can also.
So these are some of the very important terms which we can use in nursing administration or in administration. Let us talk about elements of administration. What are some of the elements of administration vis-a-vis its process and objectives?
Administration is a combination of the purpose and the means of achieving of that purpose. So nursing services administration is a complex of elements in interaction. It results in the output of the patient whose health is deteriorating, maintained or improved through inputs of personal and the material resources. If we see the elements of administration, there are six aspects of the elements which are falling into two main groups, that is the process and on the other side the effect. Like these six aspects, if we see investigation, forecasting, reality, organizations, order and command. And if you see the arrows lying over there, that means they are interrelated to each other. In each of the steps, there are objectives and planning is there. In all, to carry out all these elements, there is a well-planned system behind which will give the effect later on. What is the effect? Coordination and control. So if we see the investigation part, we collect the facts and then put these facts in the light of expert knowledge and then plan out and forecast in for the future what should be done. And the reality is when you are with the patient and taking out what you have planned in the real situation, then you organize. You can organize in the form of a chart or in order systematic manner so that you carry out the order under the control of directions or the commands. These all I have just put an arrow and put a mark as planning. That means in all these elements we have to plan out for everything to carry out certain activities, and the effect will be coordination and control.
Now if we look at the levels of management, we said that every nurse who has done or who is working even at the grassroots level, whether she is PHN or a staff nurse working in the hospital, they are all managers in their own way. Yes. But there would be certain levels of management. Yeah. Yeah. And what are the skills required for these managers, yeah, nurse managers?
Yes. Administration is applicable, as madam has rightly said, in every area and work field, whether you are in the hospital or in the community. Out of necessity, administration is required at different levels, which are termed as administrative levels. What are these levels?
Can we have slide, a slide please?
The top management, middle management level and the first management level. So in the top level of management, like in the medical colleges and hospital, there are nursing schools attached with that. So who is the manager of that medical college? The principal or the superintendent of that college is the manager, which is called as top manager or top level of management. In the middle management, nursing superintendent, principal tutors, hospital secretaries, head of the department. There are various departments and every department has got one head. So head of the departments, these are coming in the middle management. First management, tutors in the school, lecturers in the college, ward sisters in the hospitals are first level managers. So at each step, and even staff nurses, they are also managers at their own, when they are at the bedside of the patient to take care of, to make instant decisions regarding the nursing procedure which are to be carried out for the patients.
Mrs. Patni, would you like to add any other example in the community setting, giving an example of the first level, middle and top management?
In community health nursing, we have all levels of management. At the senior level, like we have DPHN, district public health nurse, maybe she is at the planning level, and when it comes to PHN, it comes to the middle level, and when it comes to ANM, that becomes the lower level. Like for example, we have various programs on NRHM is one of the latest program which has come up, which planning is done at the highest level, that is at the top level, maybe at the ministerial level, and rest execution has to be done at the PHN level and then at the ANM level. Now they say that ANM are the most involved person in NRHM, but planning is done at the top level and they are getting the work done from the lowest level.
So in NRHM, even the ASHA comes under
ANM. A&M.
And so ASHA becomes the first level worker,
yes.
And A&M becomes the middle level worker.
And so top level management, they are planning and
PHNs and all would be the top level. So I think the levels will vary according to, as you very rightly said, according to the program, according to the place of work. So that level would vary. Decision making, like nursing superintendent makes a decision, passes it on to deputy nursing superintendent and assistant nursing superintendent and departmental nursing sisters, and then it goes to the ward sister and staff nurses. So it will vary on what kind of decision is made or what kind of administration one is going through.
Yeah, but I would say that all these elements of administration goes at all levels.
Yes.
Like even A&M or ASHA, she needs to plan, organize, implement, direct, staffing, all those aspects of administration has to be at every level.
Yes.
But it is only that major work is done at the higher level.
Yeah.
But all these tasks, even a staff nurse, she needs to plan, she needs to organize.
Yeah.
So I would say that administration is at every level, whether it's the top or middle or the lowest level.
Especially in a profession like nursing, where we are dealing with the live human beings.
Yes.
So the administration has to be there because decision making is required. So what are some of the skills which are required in administration and management, Rita?
Yes, ma'am. And now the administration and management belonging to these levels require to have various skills, which falls into three main categories. First is intellectual skills, second is human skills, and third is technical skills. So the intellectual skills, if we take in detail, like it includes thinking, conceptual and decision making skills. So what is the meaning behind thinking skills? Thinking skills are those skills which have both critical and analytical components. So in critical thinking, we have to think seriously what will be the outcome, and the decisions which are made are carried out having certain risks also. So seriousness of the situation should be kept in mind and think critically, and then do the analytical thinking, like logical and the rational behind that thinking. So it is this kind of intellectual skills are mainly used at the top level of management. Another intellectual skill is conceptual thing, like ability to formulate the concepts. And decision making, like out of so many alternatives, which is the best alternative suitable for that particular organization. So these three are very essential and important intellectual skills which are used at top level of management most of the time. The second type of skills are human skills. If human beings are there, then there is thinking. So human skills are concerned with empathy, like to take the feeling of others at their own, put yourself in the situation where the patient is, and then plan out something. Then effective communication, understanding, building trust. These are the human skills which should be there. And how to make harmonious interpersonal relations. So these are part of the human skills. Then the third is the technical skills. Like you as nurses are professionally trained, you are having the various procedures which make you do again and again and become experts. We can say dexterity or handling right-handedness, perfection comes when you experience them again and again. Suppose you are doing clinical examination. So in the clinical examination, there are various positions you have to give to the patient. You have to examine each and every system in detail. Or you can take another example, like administration of injection. It is a specialized, highly complex and skilled job to give injection. So you become perfectionist in doing this.
I think very nicely on page 12 of block 1, it is given about, you know, that everyone, as Mrs. Patni mentioned, that everyone needs to have all kinds of skills.
Yeah.
And on this page it is clearly mentioned that what kind of skills are required more in the top management and in the middle management and at the lower management, grassroots level management. So if you take your block 1 and see page 12, there is this colorful diagram, you can make it out at the end of the page, which talks about that what kinds of skills are required at what level more. So that would be an excellent example.
Yes, you will find the difference. Intellectual level are higher at the top level, and then it reduces at the lowest level. Human, but technical is more at the lower level, and intellectual.
I mean, that does not mean
but
that
they need to require all these skills.
Yeah. They need to require all skills. It is only because what exercises are being done more by whom is trying to use those skills more. So all these people who are at the first level also climb up to go at the top level. Yeah. So they keep on strengthening their knowledge, and by the time they reach at the top level, their experience helps them to turn the table down. Yes, you are using that word. And then you will find they would require to have more intellectual skills. Now, what is this, I mean, how do we go about it? What is the process of administration? And what is the nature? What factors are there which affects on the nature of the administration, Mrs. Patni?
Yes. Thank you, Mrs. Kapoor. We are discussing about administration. So it has been very interestingly said by Mrs. Rita that what is administration, what is management, how do we administer. Administration is everywhere. Sitting anywhere in the classroom or in any organization or in the hospital or in a ward or at home, we are doing all administration. And administration remains the same for every organization, whether it is a hospital, whether it's a school, but the type of administration which we have to continue, it remains the same. As it has been discussed about skills, I think for better effective administration, we need to have all these skills, thinking skill, conceptual skills, and decision-making skills. This becomes an essential aspect of process of administration. Now, I would like to emphasize that a good administrator is one who gets the work done for a defined goal. So she or he must be very clear that what are her goals to be achieved and then getting the work done. Usually the nursing staff who is under the administrators, they will say, oh, she does not do anything. She is just getting the work done by us and she is sitting. But they have no knowledge that she is using her thinking skill. She is using her intellectual skill. She has to get the work done. An administrator whose people are not working, usually she says, okay, they are not doing, let me do. She is not a good administrator because she does not know how to get the work done. And if she starts doing all those technical skills and that, then her administration will suffer. So an effective administrator is the person who gets the work done from all the people intelligently. So a person need to be very intelligent, and this not necessary that a person who is intelligent can be an administrator. It is she can even learn by her training. And as Mrs. Kapoor was saying, by her experience she will grow up and she will become a good administrator. So administration process, as the name indicates, it is a continued process. We cannot say that my work is over, my administration is over. No. It keeps on going. All these elements, all this process keep on doing. Planning, first level of our administration, it goes on. Even at the last, you need to plan the evaluation. Even at the last, you need to plan for the patient discharge or for home visiting, what are the records and reports you need to plan. So planning continues, or directions continue. All these elements of administration, again, they will repeat and repeat till the work is over or till the goals are achieved. Even then we need to plan to evaluate those goals to be achieved or not. So process is a series of interrelated and interdependent functions performed by the administrator for achieving a goal. So an administrator, she has to be in coordination, in cooperation with all the people with whom she is working, by the people, for the people. So she has to get the work done, she has to interact with them intelligently. It is also involving decision making, problem solving, because in administration there may be many problems, because an administrator has to make everybody satisfied. So satisfaction of all the people will help in effective work. So a process is needing intellectual person. She can become intelligent by her experience. So once if she does something wrong, I think that's a learning for her to be effective administrator. So she handles all the situations very carefully, very intelligently, so that to see that each person in her organization is happy and she can get the work done to achieve a defined goal. We many a time say that she is a good administrator. She is not a good administrator. So this, I think she should notice that which are those points where she needs to improve, to be more intelligent, to be more. One point I would say, an administrator must be fair. But this is one point where like one lacks. Like that this. Once she is in a place, in a position, she will say, I will do what I like. No, it is what the people like, and for their fair, welfare is also very essential. So an administrator has to see that how she can get the work done and helping them also. Solving their problems. So welfare for the people is essential so that they will give a good cooperation to the administrator. She has to be dynamic. A person continues for 20 years. Another person comes in the same place and within 1 year she changes the whole ward or the whole hospital situation or all the nursing services. She is dynamic. Usually, initially, an administrator says that I will make all the changes, but these changes has to be very effective, not in a negative way. It should be in a positive way where we want that we have to make effective administration where people should admire that yes, good administration is going on. As Mrs. Rita has said that we cannot see the administration, but we can feel that there is some changes which are going on. She must be innovative. She must bring some effective changes where we can say that this administrator has made all the process of administration in act. Then it is continuous. We already discussed that it is a process which is ongoing. All these steps of administration is ongoing. They keep on doing something or the other, and all these steps are going side by side because they are interrelated to each other. So if one step is effective, rest all are based on that. So if planning is good, direction will be good, and all other steps of administration will be effective. It has to be social and human. Administration is a social activity because she has to deal with various people, and it has to be in coordination with other people, because an administrator has to be, if it is in a hospital, she has to be in work with various other departments, with various nursing personnel, with the top as well as with the bottom. Like if she is DNS, she has to coordinate with the ANS, she has to coordinate with the NS, with the CNO, with the medical superintendent, with the patient, patient's relative, and all others. So it is a social being, so she has to be social and coordinate effectively with all of them. Now, if we talk about the nature of administration, we need to keep these points in mind that there are certain aspects which help us to determine that what type of nature the administration is. First, it is universal and holistic. It is universal, as we discussed, that any organization, whether it's a hospital or a school of nursing, whether it is engineering administration, any which you take the name, but administration remains the same. The steps you need to plan, you need to organize, you need to direct, you need to have the staffing, you need to budgeting, you need to record and report, and the coordination. So these steps of administration is same for all. So we can say that irrespective of the type of organization and the goals to be achieved, our elements of administration are universal. Whether you are working in community health, it again remains the same. Whether the organization is giving preventive care, promotive care, curative or rehabilitative, again we would say that administration is same. It is holistic. It is holistic because all these aspects or elements are considered in administration. If we have to have, we have to plan for anything, there we need to direct, organize. So all these elements of administration are related to each other. So we will say that we cannot say, no, planning is over, my work is over. No, then we have to get the work done. We have to record and report, coordinate the work. So all these aspects will say that it is holistic. Then it is intangible. It is intangible because, as it has been already discussed, that it cannot be seen, but we can feel it, that something is going on. care for the patient, planning, organizing, providing care, implementation, evaluation, this is going on. The patient is getting the care, the patient is progressing, the ward is going on very smooth, systematically is going on. We don't know how it has been done, but it has been planned, organized, directed in such a manner that we can see that this ward is running smoothly. It is continuous and ongoing. We have already discussed that it is continuous. If planning is done, recording and reporting is the last, again we start for planning, or it is the, again is discussed that we all these steps go on side by side. It is goal oriented. The first point which we need to keep in mind in our administration is that we need to have set certain goals, set certain objectives, and as it is said that we need to have some purpose. We cannot work without a purpose. We need to have set of objectives which need to be achieved. The goal of a hospital is to see that patient is getting quality care and patient is progressing and go back home safely and with full cure. So this may be the objective of an organization. The objective of nursing services is that patient giving quality care to the patient. Now if we have this goal, in that case we need to plan, we need to have our complete administration in such a manner that how can we give quality care to the patient. That means we have to have quality staff, we need to have good coordination, we need to have good records and report system, we need to have good direction, the staffs, all posting should be in such a manner that everybody is happy and satisfied and is expert in giving its own work. So we have to keep all these points in mind that every point has the quality and we are able to give quality care. At the end we say that we are able to provide quality care to all types of patients. It is social and human. It has been discussed that it is a care to the social being and it is interacting with various types of people. It is making them job satisfaction. It is making all patients satisfied. So it is the administrator need to be social. She must have good human relationship. She must have group dynamics. She must have good communication skills. So she is able to speak effectively to all the people with whom she is interacting, so that has effective impact on the people. Then it is dynamic, as it is already discussed, that you need to bring some change in it. It should not just be so monotonous that the work is going on as it is. No. A good administrator must bring some changes, some effectiveness in planning, in organizing, in getting the work done, so that she has to see that how intelligently she solved all the problem, how intelligently she makes the decision, so that the whole administration is very effective. She must be creative and innovative. You bring some good creations, or it should be innovative. We should be updating our knowledge. She can be knowledgeable, or she can bring some new things in her own organization so that people say that some changes have taken place and she is very creative and innovative. So this is all about will determine these the nature for an administration.
I think these are very well covered up, that as a part of it you have also mentioned about the features other than the nature. And I thought if a student of nursing, they are clear about that what is the nature and the features of nursing administration, probably it gives them a meaning that administration is not only to do certain things, but it has got many other factors which make them a good administrator. Like you mentioned that holistic approach is to be used. The administration which is done in an intangible way, it is shown in the ward. Rita also mentioned that how effective the care is being given. So I think these are dynamism used by the administrator, brings the changes. And very rightly you said, bringing a changes is not for the sake of bringing a change, but bringing a change for the sake of satisfaction of the patients, satisfaction of the teamwork, and also satisfaction of the organization. That's more important. Am I right?
Yes.
You want to add something more? Okay. So I was thinking, let's go to a very important point, that what are the ways by which we can make our administration and management effective? How can we make the effective administration and management for smooth running of the services. Can we go to that?
Yes. This is of course one of the very important aspects, that how can we make our administration very effective. Because if we see to our practical nursing profession, I would say in most of the higher places or higher post, top level management, it is meant by just by seniority. I have seen many examples. A person who is just a general nursing, she becomes chief nursing officer. So she becomes chief nursing officer, but not necessarily she is an effective administrator, because she does not have any training or any such experience of being an administrator. So this is emphasized that for to be a good administrator, she must be qualified. Either you get a knowledge by in-service, or she gets by informal or whatever manner, but she must be qualified to be a good administrator, because she has to administer the whole nursing services of a big institution. So she must be knowledgeable. She must have knowledge about administration. Without knowledge of administration, anybody can run, no problem. Administration can be done. But how effective, that makes the difference. The knowledge input is one of the essential aspects, that she must have adequate knowledge, not only on administration, she must be knowledge about her technical skills,
yes,
about her advanced scientific knowledge. She must have all latest current affairs, whatever, she must have a broader knowledge about the whole world, what is going on. And nowadays I think we can easily grasp the knowledge by internets or through medias. There are so many sources of information. So she must update her knowledge so that she can, other people will also be influenced, because an administrator has to influence other people. So if it is a higher post, they all need to have professional knowledge, need to have technical knowledge and the scientific knowledge, so that she, the other people will accept her as an administrator. The knowledge of organization policies and rules. She cannot run the organization or administration what she wants. It is she has to follow certain rules and regulations, she has to follow certain policies, and she has to understand those policies and then apply those for all together. Because if she understands this policy, she has to go through that line, that I only follow these policies, so that it is applicable same to all. So she can be more objective. She must have leadership skill. An administrator is just a leader. She must be able to influence the people. She must be, because she is leading a whole group. She may be leading 500 nurses.
Yes.
She may be leading 600 nurses. So either she must be a good leader so that she guides them properly. If she is not a good leader, she may misguide them, and then frustrations, conflicts and more problems, and you cannot give the quality work to the people. So she must be able to get the work done from the people, and she needs to have all leadership qualities, either by learning or by experience or through her education. She must have communication skill. I said that each administrator must be effective communication. Miscommunication may lead to poor administration. You may convey something else, and message may be something else. I mean, received may be something else. So she must know what message to be conveyed, at what time, to whom all, and what are the means of conveying. Written, verbal, feedback, all these communication skills are very, very essential for her. So she must be very careful in giving instructions to the people when she wants to get the work done from her. Then technical skills, I discussed that she must have thorough knowledge about her nursing skills. She is taking around in all the wards in the whole hospital, but she herself may not be knowing some of the, you know, gadgets which are used or new procedures which have come up, but she is taking around. But she must be competent. Whatever is going on, she must know what is going on, and if possible, she must have knowledge about all types of work which is going on in various fields. Then human relation skills. She must have good human relations with all the people. We discussed earlier that she is interacting in various departments with various people, so she must be able to deal in a fair manner, and dealing with different people, how she can interact with them so that she is able to impress them in a better manner. So it is get along well with all. Then public relation and image building. she must have good public relation with all the people, because this is usually it is affected in our nursing profession. Usually it is said that she is not behaving properly, she is not talking properly. Maybe they don't understand the problem what we are facing, maybe because of many other reasons. There are so many reasons, but still, to the people who are taking our impression, maybe if we have good relation with them, good humor relations, that carry our profession as a good, that this profession is a noble profession. So these are some of the things I think she needs to keep in mind when talking about this.
Okay, I think they may look that as if you are aware of it. You are aware of it, but it is a reminder to you that to be a good administrator, you need to keep updating your knowledge and skills. And that is why you are doing your higher education, so that you are able to update your knowledge, skills, technical skills, as well as interpersonal skills and intellectual skills. Also, leadership skills. I think the very fact, the very sentence opened by Rita was that nurse is a manager at all level, whether working in the administration side, services side, in the hospital or in the community. Also, the communication skills and technical skills are very important, including the human relation skills. Public relation skills are really required, because the nurse becomes the mouthpiece of the organization. All the impressions are going to go from the administrator that how the hospital is developing, and there has to be system of routines that how a nurse should be able to make decision independently, and for what she or he has to go to the administrator to find out what is to be done next. Of course, this is the reason that you want to safeguard the establishment and the assets of the establishment and manage the personnel effectively, and that is why we want to learn about the management and administration. We are still looking forward to having calls from the regional centers. We haven't had any call, and I'm really surprised that we have not heard anything. Either you are not able to get through the lines, please then send us facts or inform us how many students, by even a note or email later on, that how many students attended the teleconference. Kindly get the feedback pro forma field. Are there any students in Delhi? If they are sitting, please connect them, help them to connect so that they can communicate with us. With this, I would like to thank Mrs. Rita and Mrs. Sunita Patni for being with us and making the concepts very clear. Thank you very much to both of you.